Hello, my name is Mike. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create compensation models. Building compensation models can help align budgets and compensation awards with company pay practices and guidelines. You can determine manager budgets based on criteria such as performance ratings or current compa ratios of eligible workers in their organizations. You can also automatically allocate compensation amounts based on each worker's country, job, grade, and quartile. Here are all the plans with active compensation cycles. I can create models for any of these plans that are set up to allow model creation. I can see all the models I've created and any global models available to me. Global models are created by compensation administrators for managers to use. I'm going to create a performance management salary model for the 2020 annual compensation plan. Model properties determine how the model is built and who can access it. The allocation method determines the values I can enter in the model. Models allow up to 4 criteria. In this case, I want to model by 2 criteria, job and performance rating. By default, the model includes all workers eligible for the component. For this model, I want to remove the workers who are about to transfer to another team. Elizabeth Mavery's team will be transferring, so I do not want her included or anyone who reports to her. I'll model an increase of 3% on the eligible salaries of all analysts with a meets expectations performance rating. Ratings of 4 and 5 increment at a 1% increase each. Then I'll select the model purpose. A model can be applied as budget amounts, compensation amounts, or target amounts, depending on the available options. For this model, I'm going to apply as budget amounts. If we were using manager-level budgeting, the sum of each worker's individual modeled amounts would determine each manager's budget amount. Now that I've selected all the criteria, I'll take a look at the results. I can go through the results and see how the model affected the amounts allocated to workers. Then, I can decide if and how I want to apply the results. I want to use this model to replace my existing budget values. Now that I've saved and applied the model to budgets, I can start allocating compensation. This concludes the Creating Compensation Models tutorial. Thank you.